Here's a closer look at the FXR Squadron Jacket. First thing you need to know about this jacket, it's part of the crossover lineup of jackets from FXR, which basically means this is a multi-purpose jacket. Take it out into the backcountry, hit up some powder, go into the woods, or just bring it off some cross-country trails, and it's going to work great either or. So while this is a crossover jacket, the liner isn't going to be removable, and it is going to have an insulated liner, which might get a little bit hot at times. So what we have is a 200 gram thermoflex throughout the center of the jacket, and then on the sleeves where you don't need as much warmth, it's going to be 150 grams. Now when it comes to those crossover jackets, this is going to be at the lower end of the price point, and the main reason for that is we're not going to be using the ActiveX Pro technology. This is just going to be ActiveX. So your breathability and waterproofing is going to be laid down a notch if you're going to be spending lots of time either sweaty, hot conditions, or in lots of slush, snow melting on you. Then you might want to go up a level in this jacket. In terms of that waterproofing and breathability, we're going to have 5,000 milligrams waterproofing and 5,000 grams per square meter in breathability. Comparing that to something a level up from the jacket, we're looking around 20,000 and 8,000. All right, so now I'm going to slip this jacket off and we'll go over some of the features in a little bit more depth. Okay, so now the jacket's off me, let's dive into it a little bit more. So first of all, you're gonna notice it does have a hood and this is removable. You simply just unsnap the two sides and then you'll find that there's a zipper on the back of it that you can easily quickly undo. So now if we put that aside, you're gonna find that there's a main pocket here in the front and that's gonna use the dry vent system. So it's gonna be breathable, but you won't get any snow melting and going through into your jacket. Then again, we're gonna have that same dry vent technology and venting system underneath your arms. And then up into the jacket here, we're gonna have a nice big side pocket on your upper arm. Right by that, we are gonna have some reflective 3M Scotch light here. Then going down into the end of the jacket, we do have a nice big Velcro strap, as well as some spandex here with a thumb hole to prevent both wind and snow from getting down your sleeve. Now I'm gonna open up the jacket here. You're gonna see that these zippers are gonna be YKK and waterproof. And same with the main zipper through here. This is actually the newer version of the YKK zipper. Just adds a little bit of the styling aspect to it. You get to see the nice green throughout the entire zipper instead of the waterproofing over top of it. Now just before I open this guy up completely, there's gonna be the standard pockets down by your hands with the fleece lining. And then there's also going to be the D-Link. So we got this guy open, and as I said, this is going to be an insulated jacket, primarily designed for multi-purpose style riding, so you can take it out to the backcountry or go on the trails with it. Depending on the weather, you might want to put on some layering, and then because of that, we are going to have the windskirt down at the bottom. And going up, this is going to be the insulated area here that you can see, and it's not removable, it's attached to the jacket. And our standard pockets in the chest area. And then the nice fleece finishing around the collar. That was a closer look at the FXR Squadron Jacket. If you're looking at going a step up from this, you can look at something like the Recoil, or if you want something similar to this but with the removable liner, then the Boost will be for you. If not, then this is the perfect entry-level jacket to get started with.